Hey guys, welcome back to another GTA 5 tutorial. We're gonna go ahead and install the Life Invader Heist. This is a really cool, simple, small mod right here. If you wanna go ahead and give it a try and see if this mod is for you, and then you can go ahead and use it however you so choose in terms of your role play. All right, so if you want to go ahead and give this mod a try, guys, go ahead and download the volume one, the one that says current, and then over here, guys, make sure you read the full description of this mod right here. And of course, a big shout out to the author of this mod right here. All right, and over here, in terms of the requirements, it says you need your the last version of scriptov.net and the last version of the scriptov as well. I have to say, guys, I am on the current version of GTA 5. I'm on the current version of scriptov. I'm on the current version of scriptov.net as well. So this mod, if it works for me, it should work for you as well. So do not worry too much about the last version or the last version over here as well. If you are on the current version of everything, I think this should work for you as well. All right, so if you want to go ahead and give it a try, go ahead and download this volume one current version right here, and then we're going to go ahead and minimize this page. And what we are going to need first is our GTA 5 main directory, and then over here on my right hand side, I do have the mod downloaded as well. We are not going to be installing the scriptov and the scriptov.net as well. I'm just going to go ahead and leave a couple of links in the description, guys, just in case you might not have this done. All right, so in order for us to install this mod, guys, just gonna go ahead and open up this mod here real quick, and then I'm gonna go ahead and do the owners and unzip my files here real quick. Let me just go ahead and close this page, then I'm gonna go ahead and move this one over here, and then on my right hand side, I do have the Life Invader Heist over here, and then over here I do have my GTA 5 main directory, and then we're just gonna go ahead and go into our scripts folder right here. And once we are in our scripts folder, we're just gonna go ahead and drag and drop both of these two files inside our scripts folder, just like so. And once you have that done, guys, you are pretty much done with the install, given that you do have all the requirements installed as well. So now we're gonna go ahead and close everything and run the game. Alrighty, guys, we are in the game, so we're gonna go ahead and test out this mod, what do you call it, Life Invader Heist right here. So let's go ahead and get inside this vehicle. So once you do jump into the game, and if you want to go ahead and activate this mod, it says you need to go ahead and press I on your keyboard. So let's go ahead and press I, just like so, and then you're gonna go ahead and get this message on top of a mini map. It says, it's Alex, it says, hi, remember me, I'm one of your contacts, go meet, and I have a job for you. And then you do have a waypoint to go, so let's go ahead and make our way to this waypoint here real quick and figure out what the hell is happening, and then we're gonna go ahead and go from there. Yeah, so it's pretty much that easy with this mod right here, but it does involve a little bit of shooting around and everything like that. So you might need to make sure, I'm not really good at shooting, so I'm just gonna go ahead and cheat a little bit just for the purposes of this tutorial right here. And of course, you can go ahead and play this out in default if you want to. All right, if you want to go ahead and get the full experience of this mod right here, you can go ahead and play it out however you choose. For me, I'm just gonna go ahead and cheat a little bit, you know. It's not too bad. Whoa, I just crossed a red light and there's a cop right here, mate. Fuck me. And I'm close to the spot as well. All right, let's go ahead and get this ticket here real quick. And the other thing, guys, I did get a lot of comments, people telling me that some of their mods are not working, especially for is it LSPD file or something like that. But I am going to be doing a full install for my LSPD file, a full fresh install for my LSPD file. And once again, I'm going to go ahead and try to take that opportunity to do a tutorial, a fresh tutorial. That will be the current tutorials for LSPD file that I'm going to be doing very, very soon. So make sure you go ahead and stay tuned to the channel, guys, and make sure you do follow as I say, because if you don't follow as I say and you don't really know what the hell you are doing, you are going to go ahead and make some mistakes, and of course your game is not going to function properly. All right, so right now we are reaching this spot over here. As you can see over here, we do have a couple dudes. They seem to be very mean dudes over here. So let's go ahead and meet up with these bozos over here and see what the hell is going on. We're gonna go ahead and go into this yellow circle right here. And then once you get to the yellow circle, it says press your D-pad right on your controller, or this could be E on your keyboard to start the heist right here. So let's go ahead and press my D-pad right. It says I will do it quick, get to Life Invader, blah blah blah. Couldn't even read the full thing, but right now, as you can see right now, the script has crossed. All right, and the other thing, guys, that's what so we're gonna go ahead and reload the script, and then we're gonna go ahead and try this mod again. All right, so if you watched my other tutorials, guys, on some real life mods, I did inform you that you're gonna go ahead and need to change your ini when you do install scopov.net. you are going to go ahead and need to change some things on your ini. So right now I am going to go ahead and reload this, all my scripts. I'm just gonna go ahead and press insert on my keyboard. The screen is gonna go ahead and freeze for a couple seconds or a minute or so, just to reload everything, and then we're gonna go ahead and restart this script. Hopefully this time around is going to work. As you can see right now, on top of my minimap, my LS life has reloaded again. So right now, let me go ahead and press I again. All right, and then we're gonna go ahead and get more of this dude to spawn over here as well. So hopefully that's not going to crash my game, but let's go ahead and go yellow circle right here. It's gonna go ahead and ask us to press our D-pad right on the controller, or this could be E on your keyboard. All right, so let me go ahead and press E on my keyboard, and then it's gonna go ahead and tell me the information that I do need. And as you can see right now, it says get in your car at the back. Okay, so the car that we are going to use for this script right here, guys, is going to be over here. All right, so let's go ahead and get inside this vehicle right here. And the other thing, guys, I did tell you that I'm gonna go ahead and cheat a little bit. So let me go ahead and bring up my simple trainer right here. And for my simple trainer, I'm just gonna go ahead and go to options, and then I'm gonna go ahead and go to guard mode right here, because I don't want to die during the shootout, because I want to go ahead and get this tutorial over and done with. All right, so you can go ahead and play without going into guard mode if you want to, but for the purposes of this tutorial, let me just go ahead and do that. All right, so with the multiple reloads that we did have ourselves a couple dudes to spawn around over here. And once again, let me go ahead and bring up manual once again. I'm gonna go ahead and take these guys out of the game right here, because they might cause the game to crash, and I don't want that at this very moment in time. All right, so with that said, guys, we do have ourselves a blue waypoint that we need to go ahead and go to, and then we're gonna go ahead and go to Life Invader. All right, we're gonna go ahead and go to Life Invader with this one to initiate this heist here real quick. All right, and once you get to this wall, getting pulled over again, fuck off. I should have disabled I should have disabled pull me over when I did this. But anyways, let's go ahead and wait for to get this ticket here as well, and then we're gonna go ahead and proceed with the heist. Right, and for some people, pull me over is not working. Like, for real, guys, look, when I say, well, when you go ahead and follow my tutorials, when I say go ahead and start from the top and make your way down, that's for a reason, guys. Especially if you are new into GTA 5 modding, you don't really understand too much about it. When I say go ahead and start from the top and make your way down on my tutorials, that's because everything is already set up for you. All you gotta need to do is just follow the videos as you see on the list. All right, And that way, guys, I'm trying to go ahead and make sure you minimize as many mistakes as possible, trying to make sure your game is functioning properly. All right, once you get to this point, somewhere around, I think around here, so your vehicle is going to go ahead and stop, and then you're going to go ahead and get this message on top of your minimap as well. It says, before you go, I just want to let you know that I have marked the enemies through whatever. And then now we do have a chance to go ahead and go into Life Invader. We can go ahead and pull in right here with me and my two goons right here. Since I'm already on God mode, so I'm not really going to die, so let me just go ahead and pick up a weapon that I'm gonna go ahead and use to try and take down some of these morons over here. So we're gonna go ahead and take out this god right here. All right, go ahead and take out this guy over here. Where's the other one? They already took out this guy over here, and now we're gonna, whoa, fuck is wrong with this guy? Come outside, mate. And now your job is gonna need to be able to take out some of these guards right here. I think there's going to be a lot of them, so we're gonna go ahead and take them out just like so. Go ahead and take them out just like so. All right, and we need to go ahead and make our way upstairs here real quick. All right, who's gonna rush me? All right, so we're gonna go ahead and just walk through Life Invader right here, just like so. Go ahead and take out some of these morons here real quick. All right, take him out. All right, we do have somebody else coming out. Go ahead and take him out as well. Gonna go ahead and take this fool out as well. What the fuck? I think there could be one more or something like that. We need to go ahead and go inside this room right here, and we're gonna go ahead and take out this fool over here as well, make sure he's dead. And once you have that done, guys, you're gonna go ahead and get this yellow marker around over here, and then over here it's gonna go ahead and say press your D-pad right or E on your keyboard to plant the bomb. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and plant the bomb here real quick, and then you're gonna go ahead and get this message. It says, dealer, get in your car outside. So now we're gonna go ahead and go outside here real quick, and we're just gonna go ahead and get inside our vehicle, and then we will have the opportunity to kind of like run away or something like that. I think we're gonna need to lose the cops from this point. Where are my goons at? I don't know where are my goons at. All right, did they die? Did those fools die? Yeah, we got one dead right here. I think both of them died. Nope, only see one. Who the fuck is the other one? I don't see the other one. But anyways, let's go ahead and get inside our vehicle here real quick. And once you are inside the vehicle, guys, you're gonna go ahead and get this message right here to press your D-pad left to detonate the bomb inside. So let's go ahead and press our D-pad left just like so, and then you're gonna go ahead and get this animation showing you the blow, you blowing the blowing up the inside of Life Invader. And now we're gonna need to go ahead and lose the cops right here. All right, I think I know, take this out using my simple trainer, but we're gonna go ahead and play this out here real quick. We're just gonna go ahead and go underground over here. The police are not going to follow us down here, so this is a pretty cool and a really nice place to hide from the police. Every time you're being chased around, you just go ahead and go underneath over here. And so now we're gonna go ahead and just wait for the stars to go away, and then we're gonna go ahead and finish off the mission. Alrighty, guys, after a while been just chilling right here, we've managed to run away from the cops, and now we are stars free. Now we can go ahead and follow up with the mission and make sure we do complete our mission, and then we're gonna go ahead and get paid. And I have to say, this mod does have potential. This mod, I think with future updates, it could be very, very good. Maybe if you add a couple of things into it and maybe a little bit more. I mean, in terms of the payments, if you go ahead and make the payment a little bit more handsome, I think this mod can be very, very good in future uploads or future updates, I should say. All right, so right now we are making our way to this point over here. All right, now I don't have my waypoint anymore. But I can go ahead and just show you where we are going. We are going to this location right here. All right. So if you do, if your waypoint disappears, just know that you are going into this location right here. All right. So let's go ahead and make our way to the location. We are pretty much done with the hard stuff right now. We are just making our way over this way to get paid. All right. And make our way over here. We're just gonna go ahead and bulldoze our wall. Get out of my way. Just gonna go ahead and bulldoze our way in. I do need some food as well. Yo, there's a cop right here and my vehicle is damaged. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and pull in right here, and once we do pull up in here, we're gonna go ahead and see these two dudes standing at the corner right here with the yellow circle. This is where we need to be. So we're gonna go ahead and go right here. And then we need to go ahead and step inside this yellow circle right here. And of course, you're gonna go ahead and get another notification in your top left corner. It says, press your D-pad left or E on your keyboard to sell the stolen data from Life Invader database. All right, so let's go ahead and do that. And once we are done that, the dealer is gonna go ahead and say good job and get your bag at the back. All right, so in order for us to get our bag and get paid, we need to go ahead and come over this way, and the bag is going to be over here. All right, and once we collect the bag, it's going to be $50,000, and that's pretty much it on that. I am a little bit disappointed on the amount of money that you get paid for this, especially if it's like data, like Life Invader data. It should be a million minimum as far as I'm concerned. Maybe in the near future we'll have an INI in order for us to edit some of this stuff into the game or something like that. I don't know, but I think that would be a cool feature. Or maybe make it a little bit more lifelike. All right, and so guys, with that said, really, that is pretty much it about the Life Invader heist. I think there should be more into it as far as I'm concerned, but for what it's worth, I think it is what it is. But hopefully you guys did enjoy this episode right here. Hopefully you guys did enjoy this tutorial. And of course guys, if this tutorial helped you what to install and you like the mod and all of that jazz, please do consider subscribing to the channel on the road to 1,000 subscribers. But with that said guys, thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for subscribing, and I'll catch you guys next time. I think right now I need to see if I can go ahead and steal a car and go about my business for the day or something like that. But anyways, I'll see you guys next time, man.